customer service evaluation is a process that helps you to evaluate which of your services are efficient and which are not. It also helps you to determine how satisfied the customer was with the service that was provided. Customer service evaluation can also help you to allocate your resources more efficiently so that you can improve the services that you are offering to your customers, as well as meeting any of the specific requirements or needs. There are different ways to evaluate your customer service. One way is to monitor and assess the performance of your staff. This can be done by keeping a check on customer feedback through questionnaires, customer forums, and word of mouth, as well as feedback in the form of complaints and external comments. Some businesses use mystery customers who monitor and report the quality of customer service. Another good way to gauge on how you're performing is through your sales performance and your repeat customers and your retention of customers, as well as the number of new customers. Try to make a note of all this and put it into a database or a spreadsheet at the end of each month. You can have one column for new customers and one column for return customers. And at the end of the month, compare the ratio. Always ask new customers how they heard about you and make a note of what that was. If it was through word of mouth or through a recommendation from a friend or a family member, then you know that you're doing something right. Design the evaluation process if you already haven't done so. You should identify the purpose of evaluation. Make sure that you are clear on the services that are being evaluated, for example, fast or timely deliveries, quality of products, knowledge of products and services, staff approachability and friendliness. The evaluation can be carried out in the form of formal customer surveys or by asking customers before they leave your business or by emailing out questionnaires and so on. Now, once you have the results of these assessments or evaluations, they should be discussed at a meeting involving everyone. They should provide you with information on the areas that need improvement and help you to take remedial actions in those problem areas. Now, this is your final exercise for this session. I want you to get yourselves into two separate groups, and if you currently don't evaluate your customer service, make a list of all the ways effective evaluation will benefit you and your company. I also want you to brainstorm and to make a note of the ways that you can evaluate your customer service. What would be the best method for your particular business? To conclude this session, look at your training objectives, read out your list of outcomes that you have made at the beginning of the workshop, and see whether these were met. Make a list of what you learned today and what stood out for you. What did you find most valuable from this training? List the ways that you intend to implement the training. And finally, I want to thank each and every one of you for participating in this training. And I'm confident that whatever you got out of this workshop will help you to become more confident, more effective and efficient when dealing with customers. Thank you for staying with me till the end, and I hope that you enjoyed your customer service training and found these tips useful. Wishing you every success in your retail career.